Hey, what's up guys, welcome back, you're watching Fruitake. Last time we reviewed one of the oldest ROM of custom ROM world, that is derfest OS. So I decided to review another gem of old is gold series custom ROM, one of that is a Bliss OS. Bliss OS actually famous for their Android x86 project for PC and laptops. But they also have their own custom ROM development for lots of officially supported Android devices. And we also got its custom GSI build, which should work for all Android devices running above Android 11 version with projectable support and ARM64AB dynamic system. So we booted the latest Bliss OS GSI on our OnePlus 9RT. In today's video, we are going to review its new source base, its unique new features. At the end of this video, we discuss what's working and the bugs of the GSI build with my final verdict. So this video will be useful for all Android device users which are already running with the old Bliss OS custom ROM and the users who want to flash this custom ROM or a custom GSI. They will get the clear-cut idea how Bliss OS and it's really worth to try on your device or not. Now without further delay, let's get started. First, we will check out the source base and the version details of this build. Bliss OS version is 18.5. This is the latest version of this ROM with the code name Wigh. Except that other details like Bliss device maintainer will be as per the official custom ROM if you are using the Bliss custom ROM, while for custom GSI build, these details will remain unknown. Build date of this GSI is of latest 3rd May 2025. This is the Android 15 build with the April 2025 security patches. Kernel is enforcing and its version is 5.4.254, which is built with the latest Clang toolchain 11. Now we will discuss some of the customizations of this build. In the settings, we will get the Blissfully option, which have all the old school customization, which can provide you the heavy customization features using the buttons, gestures, lock screen, notifications, QoS settings, status bar, themes, and miscellaneous customization options. In the QoS setting options, some interesting feature I got. One of that is a data usage toggle, which enables the data usage details in the QoS panel of your device. Second is a QoS panel battery style. This is a separate customization of clock style for QoS panel, irrespective of status bar clock customization. Who gets bunch of the different QoS panel clock style, which looks cool. This ROM offers square and rounded shaped QoS panel tiles and both combined circle and square styles. When the tile toggle is turned on, it converts its shape into the circle one, and when it's turned off, it goes in a square shape. Except this, QoS panel style option offers different presets of QoS panel. I especially liked the surround style of QoS panel. All of this customization looks similar to the Google's new user interface for Android 16. We also get the Bluetooth tile dialog toggle, which enables the expanded view of Bluetooth tile in a QoS panel, like network tile. Next, like most highly customizable ROMs, we got some miscellaneous advanced features like play integrity fix, Lexel props device setting, storage encryption is one of the different settings which I not found for different ROMs. Snapchat spoofing toggle helps to solve Snapchat is not working issue in Android 15 custom ROMs. Even we get the app sidebar in this ROM for true multitasking, but it has some issues that we'll discuss in the bug section of this video. In the navigation mode option, we get the task manager, which is very useful tool for large screen Android devices. By swiping up on the navigation bar wheel, we can access the taskbar anywhere in the operating system. Taskbar offers all the dock application and app drawer in the taskbar, so we can open these apps in a split screen with the current running application. We can access the app drawer using the taskbar anytime in the system. Taskbar is not a new feature, but in a previous build for highly customizable ROM, it's not fluid. New taskbar is smooth to use without any lag. Bliss OS is one of the few custom ROM which offers audio effects, audio tuner for your Android device, which is one of the best mod to fine-tune your device audio like Dolby Atmos. Bliss OS offers the game mode like most of custom ROM with all the features for better performance and interference-free gaming. But it has one new setting called as Quick Start Applications. Here you can choose any application to quickly start them. You can choose non-gaming applications in this setting. This ROM has their own weather widget called as OmniJaws, which offers some customizations to tune its user interface. This widget looks cool on the home screen. ROM has fully working Google circuit to search. But after first boot, you need to update your Google application to make it work properly. Google Gemini is also working fine and it can be activated by swiping from the bottom right or left corner or by using long press power button shortcut. ROM comes with the new Bliss launcher, which has all advanced features for launcher customization and have a bunch of the different Bliss ROM exclusive wallpapers. You can add Google new search bar with new music search shortcut using the Bliss launcher. This one is one of the most accurate music search feature like now playing, and it's accessible anytime on the home screen. So we discuss almost everything. So what are bugs of the GSI? Remember, custom ROM users will not face such major bugs that I am going to show you. After first boot, you may get the misalignment for the status bar and punch hole camera. It can be solved easily using the display cutout and the punch hole cutout option available in the developer setting. Like all the GSI build, VoLT calling is not working for me in this build also. Whenever I try to call LTE network, it switches to 2G calling. Fingerprint unlock is not working in this ROM, but you can use face unlock feature. After setting the face unlock, just reboot the device into Bliss OS again. Now this feature should work fine. All the play integrity checks are failing in this ROM, even though I tried all the miscellaneous advanced features to solve this issue. Device Play Protect is not certified, but still most of the applications like Access Banking application, WhatsApp are working for me. But only SBI YONO application not working, it's force closing. It may be because of bootloader unlock spoofing option which showing the bootloader locker in my device in a developer option. Next issue I found for the app sidebar feature. After first time setup, it worked fine, but later it was not accessible for me in the system. This is all about for Bliss OS 18. This is the oldest and most famous ROM in the custom ROM world. If all the security apps are working for this custom GSI, then it can be considered as a daily driver build for your device. Users who are already using the Bliss custom ROM on their device and all officially supported devices can definitely upgrade their device to the latest Bliss version for more stability and performance. That's it for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.